Hi, my name is Bastian, as you heard. I work at the Yale University, and I'm a PhD student in signal processing. In particular, I work with speech data, which means I work with audio data in Python. Can I show a quick show of hands? Who of you has worked with audio data in Python? Few, but a few, okay. So what is audio data, really? When we take a measurement with our microphone, when we record some audio, the microphone takes these minute sound pressure level measurements of the ambient air pressure, basically, at a sample rate of maybe a few tens of thousands per second. This is, of course, a huge array of floats then that we can use, and there are many functions in SciPy and Matplotlib to work with audio data. But the really neat thing about audio, of course, is that it can be played and it can be heard by, you know, human ears. Also, audio data has a few dedicated file formats, which is not usual for all the scientific data we use, especially, you know, WAV files, MP3 files. So these are the two things I want to talk about today. One, how to work with audio files in Python, and two, how to play and record audio. First up, audio files. When I came to Python, there wasn't really a cool library for reading audio files or reading parts of audio files. But I was a C programmer at the time, and I knew that there was a library called libsndfile, which is, you know, open source and cross-platform, really cool. So at the time, well, I had to create a new library for Python called soundfile. You can see an example on the right. You can read a sound file by just, you know, read file name. You can write your audio data to a new sound file by giving it a file name and some data on a sample rate. But many of our audio files are kind of huge and we don't want to read them all into memory in one go. So we tend to process them in a block-by-block fashion, reading one block at a time, then moving on to the next. So of course, soundfile can do that too, and it can read any file-like object, actually, which is super handy if you have like a network stream with audio data, or if you have your database cursor or whatever. And of course, these are huge files, so we sometimes want to read just part of a file, just the end maybe, without loading the whole thing into memory. So soundfile does that. Been around for a few years. It works really well. I think we have found most of the bugs so far. So moving on to the second part. Now we can read files. Now we want to play and record audio. There's a thing about audio. When you want to play audio, your sound card will ask you for a new sample of audio data at a sample rate of maybe 48,000 times per second. And doing that in Python is just not possible. We can't run our signal processing code 48,000 times a second. So instead, you know, when we have performance problems in Python, we go down to NumPy. So that's what we do. Instead, we usually work with blocks of audio, and we say, instead of providing 48,000 samples per second, maybe let's provide 512 samples in a NumPy array every 10 milliseconds. Comes out to the same number, but is much easier to work with in Python. Make no mistake, though, when you work with audio data and you have this 10 millisecond window, you really can only take 10 milliseconds. Take even 1 millisecond longer and you get nasty clicking artifacts and everything. So this stuff often is very performance sensitive, really. So again, at the same time when we did soundfile, I also looked around and I knew there was a nice C library again cross-platform, open source, called Port Audio. Again, a great library, works well. And at the time, there was already a Python library that used Port Audio. You can see it's called PyAudio. You can see it on the right side. To use it, you instantiate the library, you open a stream, you write data to the stream, and when you're done, stop the stream, close it, terminate the library. It does work really well. However, it is a somewhat low-level binding to Port Audio. So when you write your data there, that's not NumPy arrays, that's just, you know, C-like data, so just bytes. So we're scientists, we want something nicer. We want to use NumPy. So again, you know, we had to write a new library called PySoundCard, which again uses Port Audio, but just has a bit of a nicer API. all that opening and closing from the other library is gone because we can use Python, it's nice. Just use a context manager and there you go. And of course it works with NumPy arrays. I mean, that's the point. However, this was 5 years ago maybe. And we came to see that there are just some inherent problems with using this C library port audio that we couldn't solve in our Python wrapper. For one thing, you can only select, well, you can select a subset of channels, and that's very important because we're scientists, we have this whole pro audio gear, we have 32 channels, and that's just too much to deal with in Python. We just want maybe the seventh and eighth channel of our sound card because that's where the guitar preamp is or whatever. But with port audio, you can only select the first N channels. So if I want to have channel 7 and 8 for my guitar preamp, I'll have to read the whole first 8 channels, 0 to 8. Which, you know, this is performance critical, so you don't want that. Also, port audio sometimes gets the default sound card wrong, which means that you start to play something and you don't hear anything. This is particularly bad on Linux because it uses ALSA, and that's the audio library from Linux, one of them. And the default ALSA audio device is often the system mixer, which has 128 channels. And again, that's not what you want. And finally, port audio compiles the list of available sound cards when you start the library. So you start the library and then you plug in your new USB device, it won't know about it. You change your defaults, it won't know about it. I'm not hating on port audio at all. It's actually, it is a very cool C library for very many applications. Just for this particular application, it was not the perfect fit. So I went looking for an alternative, but there doesn't seem to be any cool C library that does this low latency audio streaming that I want to do. Well, but you know, port audio itself is just using the native audio libraries of each operating system. So theoretically, I guess I could use that as well. That would mean like 3 times the code. So that's what, you know, we had to do. So I created SoundCard, a new library. It's very, very new actually this year. On Windows, it uses the Wasapi audio API. On Linux, it uses Pulse Audio, and on Mac, it uses Core Audio. These are the native audio APIs of the operating systems. And with that, finally, I can get the correct default audio devices, and I can just build a nicer API. You can see on the right side there, I can search for my default speaker on the system or my default microphone, but I can also just search for it, you know, fuzzy searching, like you would expect your API to work. And finally, I can get just the 7th and the 8th channel of my big sound card without any errors. Well, I guess I will be able to do that as soon as I implement it, but I know it's possible from the API. And since this is using the native libraries of the operating systems, I don't have to ship port audio anymore. So, you know, it's just a pure Python package, download, and of course, well, there are downsides as well. For one, it's very new. Does work. I mean, we tested it on several computers. It works on Windows, Linux, and OS X, but I totally expect there to be bugs. And it is basically using 3 different code paths for the 3 different operating systems, all implementing the same Python API. So, you know, 3 times the code, 3 times the bugs, 3 times as hard to test. Nevertheless, this library works today. And it's, I think it's the best API. I've been working on this for several years now, and I think it's the easiest API that I have come up with yet. You can just play some audio data, and it'll just play it as you would expect, but also the blocking, block by block, working with audio data that I told you about earlier works just as well. And, well, I think Python and scientific audio can be friends. And I hope that SoundCard is one more step in that direction. And if you want to help out make sound in Python better, come over to the repo, give me bug reports, pull requests. Yeah, that's all I have. Thank you.
We have time for 1 or 2 questions. So, for image processing, you have like scikit-image to do image process to, well, process images. Is there something similar for audio?
Yeah. I maybe forgot to mention that SciPy and NumPy and Matplotlib include a whole host of functions for working with audio data, and audio is kind of special in that we can hear it. So many of the functions maybe perform differently than you would expect them from other kinds of data, because everything has to make sense for our hearing. But there are especially SciPy.signal contains many very interesting functions, and Matplotlib too includes many visualization functions.
Okay, let's thank the speaker again.